What it do, it's your boy Mo Diggity, the super producer extraordinaire, man. Thank you for tuning in to Mo Diggity TV episode 2. Today I'll be breaking down a record that I already produced, man. Picking up some legs in the airwaves, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about Jake Lambo, Second Wind, produced by none other than yours truly. I'm going to show you what I did. I'm going to break down the instruments that I used, and I'm gonna give y'all a little insight on how the record came about. So, grab you some popcorn, man, and sit back and relax and enjoy the ride. Let's go. Got my second wind. I'm true to this kicking gluteus maximus, asking them how we doing. It's never fearing these rappers rapping about stupid shit. Super sick, supersonic, atomic bomb in the game. Who is this? This is Jake. Is it safe to say I'm the man? I was losing my cool, but I didn't thanks to my fans. Bars as hard as a cinder block, cinder cop. I'm a murderer, breaking into the game and take rapper spots like a burglar. All right,
so how the record came about was, a couple years ago at A3C, I ran the Playboy trade down to A3C, and you just stand in the hallway by yourself, and I was maneuvering my way through the crowd, and I saw him, and I was like, boom, perfect opportunity to stop, boom, so stop, made small talk with him, conversation, we just talked about 10 minutes, whatever, and then I followed him on Facebook, and a couple weeks later, he posted a link to his a video or artist, a song. He said, this is my new artist. I want y'all to check him out and let me know what you think. So I listened to the record and I was like, oh man, this dude's dope. You know what I'm saying? He responded. He was like, yeah, appreciate it, whatever. And he was like, maybe we can get in the studio with you and get something done. And I'm like, boy, what? I took that as a perfect opportunity to make something happen, because it's like, you know, you're going fishing. That's that bait. Threw it out there hoping somebody was going to bite on it. And it was like, here go your test. See what you're going to do. So, about a week after that, Trey brought Jake through. Jake and Javi, they came through, kicked it. And like an hour later, that Second Wind, I made it right there in front of him. Same day I met Jake, it's the same day I made Second Wind, right there in front of him. And then about a month later, I found out it was gonna be the single. A month or two after that, I found out he got signed to No Genre, and it's like, boom, now the young brother on tour. So man, just keep working, keep working these avenues until something pop off for you, man. And this just happened to be one of the ones for me, man. But I got a lot more records. I got a lot of records that I've done in this room with a lot of up-and-coming artists on the east side of Atlanta right now. So I appreciate Playboy Trey and Jake Lambo for giving me this opportunity, man, to showcase my work. So now I'm getting into breaking down this beat and showing y'all what I did, man. All right, well, how I started on this track, I actually made it in the FL studio. But somehow, I think I deleted the session or something, but luckily I have it tracked out here in Pro Tools. Thank God, Jesus, for that one. Anyway, what I did was sat in the room. I was going through some sounds, and I stumbled across the sample, and Jake heard it, and he said, what was that? His exact words, like, what was that? And I was like, cool. You like that? I love it. So as soon as I heard that, what was that? That was good enough for me to, I said, I'm going to make something with that. And it was, let me play this. This is exactly what the sample was. That's what the sample was. So that's what I started the record with. Yeah, so I started with that sample. I chopped it up and stabbed it like that. And after that, I added this Rhodes to it. After that, I think I added these organs just to give it a little soulful vibe to it, because it was already a soulful sample in the beginning with. And here we go with the organs, man. Pretty sure I came with the bass. I don't remember the exact order in which I made the record because it was a while ago. But I know I start most of my tracks with the music. The drums always come last. The drums, I don't know why that is. I was a drummer for like 5 years, but the drums always come last to me, so it's all good. But yeah, after that I added this bass. Well, this isn't the bass line that I had. The bass line I had was much simpler than this, and I actually outsourced to my homie Chris, and he played the bass for me. But on the record that you, on the original version that you hear on the video, and they have released on iTunes and stuff, make sure you go get that. The version that they have on iTunes, it doesn't have this bass line in it, because when I sent it to them, they said they didn't like the feel of it anymore. The bass line that I had changed the whole feel of the record, which it did. After I listened to it, it changed the feel of the record. And I also had some more pianos and stuff in there, but we ended up taking all that out to keep it a grungy feel, sort of a smooth grungy, not just a gritty feel, but a smooth grungy feel. So. Yes, it's safe. All right, this is the bass line that we had. After that, I'm pretty sure I added this old school lead to give it like a... That's some old school stuff I probably heard when I was a little boy, and I was like, man, that would sound good one day if I used it, so that's probably where that came from. Let's see. Got another little offset lead. I didn't play all that music together. Oh, yes, sir. Man, that's how I started the record off with all of that right there, and usually that is the meat of the record to me when I'm making my point. Anytime I'm making a beat, I build everything. I build the entire beat at one time. Like, what I feel like is going to be the hook, I put everything into one pot. And then I begin to take things away and break it down. And I'm pretty sure that's how a lot of other people do it. But, you know, I'm pretty much self-taught around here. YouTube taught and, you know, stuff like that. I went to a school, but they robbed me. And I'm not going to say the name of the school. You know who you are, you crooked bastard. You know who you are. Took my money. And everybody else money too, didn't teach us nothing. Anyway, back to the subject at hand. Alright, after that, I came with the kick drum, you know what I'm saying? Gave it an old hip hop feel. I cut this sub on, we're gonna wham. Put a little swing on the hi-hat, you know what I'm saying, a little delay on it so it'll bounce. Mm-hmm. once we got here. Play bell. And some other percussion and shit. Oh, I forgot I got these DJ, this little scratch sample down here at the bottom.
I'm true to this, kicking gluteus maximus, asking them how we doing. It's never fearing these rappers rapping about stupid shit. Super sick, supersonic, atomic bomb in the game.
Producer, man, the extraordinaire is him. I'm he. He is I. Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on Facebook. Follow me on YouTube. Download my mobile app. Yes, that is me. Mo Diggity, super producer extraordinaire, man. Yeah.
Like a burglar, you got beef, I cook burgers up. Best believe that I'm serving them, swerving, crashing. I'm blasting off niggas softer than applesauce. Pass the ball to my niggas so my whole team win. Make my way into the game and let my whole team in. Instantly snapping, I'm snapping on beats.